Hi, I am Manjot from Lens Passions Photography. In the last video, we learned about new content aware workspace. Today, I will discuss about new frame tool for easy masking. Now we can easily mask images by placing them into frames tool by using K key to quickly create rectangular or elliptical placeholder frames. Before watching this video, I request you to subscribe my channel if you don't subscribe and click on the bell so you will be notified when I will upload a new video. Now first I tell you if about a clipping mask. A clipping mask is a group of layers to which a mask applied. The bottommost layer or base layer defines the visible boundaries of the entire group. For example, select the elliptical tool from shape menu, draw a circle by holding shift key and open a new picture. Then need to add. In the layer panel, select the top layer of a pair of layers you want to group and choose layer and then create clipping mask. The layer in the clipping mask have the opacity and mode attributes of the bottommost base layer in the group. Now you can transform it by using Ctrl plus T in Windows and Command plus T in Mac. Now I am using a new frame tool for easy masking in place of clipping mask. Create frames with the frame tool by selecting the frame tools from the tools panel or press K. In the tool option bar, choose a rectangular frame or an elliptical frame. Drawing a new frame on the canvas, I am selecting an elliptical frame and drawing on the canvas. And select the image and place to the frame. Content placed in the frames is always placed as smart objects so that it can be scaled non-destructively. The content automatically scales to fit the frame. You can place content in the frame by drag an Adobe Stock asset or a library's asset from the library's panel into the frame. You can adjust frame size anytime by selecting frame mask. By clicking twice, you can adjust size and move frame anywhere by using move tool. You can also change the size of picture by selecting image mask separately. After adjusting and finalization, you can move both anywhere with single layer. In clipping mask, we have to adjust both layers separately if we want to change anything. After using frame mask by drawing frame tool, I will show you how can we convert any shape or text to a frame. I am drawing a rectangular shape from shape menu and convert into frames by choosing layer panel and then select convert to frame. Place an image into frame from your local disk into the frame, the image is placed as an embedded smart object. To create a linked smart object, hold down Alt key in Windows and Option key in Mac as you drag and drop the image. You can adjust and change the size in the same way as I mentioned before. So you can convert any custom shape to frame by choosing layer menu. Then convert to frame. Watch out. You can see I converted three shapes to the frames and dragging the images from the local disk into the frames. The image is placed as an embedded smart object. Same we can do with the text. I did it many times by using clipping on text. By hold down Alt in Windows and Option in Mac, position the pointer over the line dividing two layers. In the layers panel, the pointer changes the two overlapping circles and then click. I am choosing a layer menu and selecting convert to frame. In frame, you can also convert any shape or text into frames and fill it with images. Now I am converting text to the frames. And rest of process is the same, drag and place on the frame. Frame masking is a very powerful tool when we use this in a document. In the document, I have created two frames already, those was hided. I am unhide the both frame layers by clicking on eye icon. Here I have already added images by dragging from local drive. You can also choose images from CC libraries. Now I am creating new frame in the same document and drawing on the document and placing by dragging from local libraries. It is a very powerful tool for the document where we need to change images frequently. So you can change any picture just selecting images from frame properties menu. So selecting a frame from the menu bar, select file, place linked or place embedded. In the dialog box that appears, select an image that you want to place in the selected frame. The image is placed as a linked or embedded smart object. So you can replace any picture that was you already placed in the document. Now I am going to introduce layer comp. Layer comps allow you to create, manage and view multiple versions of a layout in a single Photoshop file. If your placeholder image is a smart object with a layer comp, you can use the layer comp drop-down to select the comp that were defined in the source file. First, we need to open a new document and then selecting the multiple images, placing them in different layers in same document. After adjusting the size of images of all layers, choosing Windows menu and selecting layer comp. Then creating each layer as a layer comp layer. Take care that layer should be visible. I am giving the name of each layer, then saving to new PSD file. Open the dead document with the frames and selecting the frame where I need to place the images. In the dialog box that appears, select an PSD file that you want to place in the selected frame. Go to again frame properties panel where you can see another dialog box named layer comp. In drop down menu, you can see all the files you added in the PSD file you selected. So you can replace any file without using dragging and placing. It's great. The another useful tool in frame properties menu, you can create strokes inside, outside and center. You can also edit contents you placed by simply clicking here because all the contents are the small object. Now that's all for today. Don't forget to comment and also don't forget to give ideas. So I create those videos that you want to watch. Thanks for watching.